Hello everyone, sanbonani, dumelang, apsheni, molweni, tobela, lochani. I hope you all good people out there. Welcome to 105 Online Channel. In this channel, we are bringing you celebrity news, entertainment news, and gossip celebrity news. If you are new into this channel, please subscribe and hit that notification button. Hey good people, today I am bringing you the latest news of Cyril Ramaphosa. The radical economic transformation lobbyists in the ANC have threatened to hold President Cyril Ramaphosa before the International Criminal Court, which is ICC, and have indicated their resolve to fight the bitter end for the control of the governing party and the release of former Jacob Zuma from jail. The group is planning for peaceful and lawful protest action next Tuesday at the Pietermaritzburg High Court, where Zuma is currently serving 15-month sentence for contempt of court, will be seeking to quash the arms deal corruption allegations against him on the grounds that the National Prosecuting Authority was biased. There is in the statement that was issued by 19 radical economic transformation activists, including Carl Niehaus and Andile Lungisa. The group listed Ramaphosa among accused who they intend to report to The Hague for indulging in ethnic or racist mobilization, which had resulted to a casual link in the Phoenix massacre, where more than 200 people lost their lives, and the final count of this racial-driven massacre is still to be announced. The victims of the Phoenix deserve and must have justice. We therefore call on progressive and well-meaning South African religious bodies, civil society movements, and human rights organizations, but locally and internationally, to join and assist in the court case with the ICC in The Hague, as well as the legal action that we are proceeding with locally at the unfitness of President Ramaphosa to hold the office. It is evident that it was President Ramaphosa's fundamentally wrong characterization of the terrible unrest and demonstration of the desperation by increasingly hopeless poor people that led to the preventable genocide that led the Indian community in Phoenix to mistakenly believe that it had carte blanche to arm itself and go on killing spree of innocent Zulu people. In terms of its founding treaty, the Rome Statute, the ICC has jurisdiction to prosecute atrocity crimes, namely genocide crimes against humanity and war crimes. The ICC gets involved where a state party or the UN Security Council or the ICC prosecutor referred the crimes to the court. The RIT blamed Ramaphosa's cabinet, and the activists also alleged that Ramaphosa had violated the constitution with regard to the way the 25,000 SA and DF troops were deployed to bring under control the public unrest that saw over 300 people lose their lives following Zuma's incarceration fortnight ago. The statement also said, "Our unequivocal demand remains that President Zuma be released forthwith. We also remain convinced that the implementation of RAT as contained in the critical socio-economic demands that had been present to Ramaphosa and which he so arrogantly refused to receive is essential to bring peace and stability to our country. The acts of looting, criminal as they may be, have demonstrated that there can never be peace and stability without equality." The group also rejected to link over campaign to the violence and looting that took place over the past weeks, saying the unfounded allegations that are leveled at the campaign are scapegoating of the worst kind by leaders and a government trying to escape their responsibilities for having failed to address the legitimate and immediate needs and demands of South Africans, in particular poor Black Africans whose daily lives are invalidated by the most basic needs and thus the resultant consequences that shook our country and the world. What do you think, people? Do you think RAT have a case or not? Please leave your comment down below. Thank you so much for watching. Please do not forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell so that you can get more news on this channel. 105 Online Channel loves you. Bye, good people.